Cluster headaches are a type of primary headaches which are different from migraines in certain aspects, especially in the specific set of symptoms they come with. The typical headache goes like this. They have these stabbing pain in one side of the face, and usually they happen in back-to-back clusters. That's why named cluster, and it can go anywhere from half an hour to 3 hours, and it can happen back-to-back over a couple of days, and it can, like, you know, happen multiple days at a time. And you also have some associated symptoms where one side of your face becomes slightly droopy, flushed, and you see sweatiness on that side, and the eye on that side becomes really red, swollen and tender, and you can see some tearing coming out of the eye, some nasal discharge. Cluster headaches are managed in two ways, like any other headaches that I treat. So there is an acute treatment and there is a preventive treatment. Acute treatment is treating a headache as and when it happens, and for that we use some specific kind of medications called triptans. So sumatriptan, zolmitriptan, these are the specific kind of triptan medications which we use to abort a headache as and when it happens. So the other part of the treatment process is preventing these clusters from happening more and more and back to back in the future. So that is what we call preventive treatment, and for that there are medications which need to be taken on a daily basis so that over long time they help prevent the frequency from increasing. So some of the medications include verapamil and even topamax, melatonin. We can discuss this with on a patient-to-patient basis, depending on the side effect profile and tolerability, but this is how we usually treat the acute and the preventive part of them. It's hard to exactly say if they would go away completely in a patient. Every patient is different and every patient reacts differently to the treatment process. So usually they are not lifelong, but if you have certain risk factors or triggers which cause these headaches in a patient, it's better to avoid them. And early and the appropriate treatment options will make sure that they don't happen as frequently, and then maybe over time they would fade away. I encourage early and appropriate intervention for these type of headaches because they can cause significant functional disability when they happen. And the other thing is the cluster headaches, they happen more in sleep. They make them wake up from sleep and they can have this nocturnal and circadian rhythm to it. So it can impair sleep and other parts of a person's life. So, and on a pain scale, they would always be on a 10 out of 10 pain scale if I ask a patient how bad they are. Thank you.